The new MacBook Pro 2022 models look like they'll be an evolution of the new MacBook Pros that we have right now. However, what will change for the next generation MacBook Pro? Well, today we're going to look into what the MacBook Pro M2 Pro and Max chipset is going to give us, and I'm also going to give you the latest details of everything we know so far, including the MacBook Pro 2023 release date and price spec summary. Hi, it's Matt here, and we now have the brand new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros with that M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset inside. Now already a lot of us are wondering what will the next generation Mac Pro give us in the likes of 2022 or 2023. Well, in this video I'm going to cover over everything we know so far for the brand new higher spec MacBook Pros that Apple will release in the future. So if you watch some of my videos already, you will know I'm going to give you the latest details from specific reports of info that we've been told, then the details of the planned release date, then a summary of the models that are going to be released with all the features that we have learnt in previous leaks as well. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next generation MacBook Pro. Also, put in the comments below of what features you would love to see in the MacBook Pros, and maybe in my next video I will feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So let's get started with the main details of the next generation MacBook Pro. So right away, let's get the elephant in the room out of the way, and that's to do with the design of the brand new MacBook Pro coming out in 2022 or 2023. It is most likely that Apple will probably not do any changes to the main design of the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pro, except for a few tiny tweaks of updated corrections that current users of the current M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBook Pros may be reporting. Apple tends to keep the same MacBook design for a good few years before they change it again. For example, back in 2008 when the unibody MacBook Pro came along, Apple upgraded the chipsets, hard drives, and other parts put inside the main MacBook Pro, but the main overall design didn't change until the Retina MacBook Pros in 2012, and then this happened again with hardly any changes until we got the Touch Bar design MacBook Pros in 2016, with the same happening all over again until we've got these brand new Apple Silicon MacBook Pros that we have today. So as you can see, the design is always around for 4 to 5 years coverage, but Apple do change the insides of these MacBook Pros. A good example of where some small changes, minus chipsets, RAM and hard drives, may happen is, for example, with the Touch Bar MacBook Pros. And they originally came with the butterfly keyboards in 2016. And as you know, if you've owned one of these MacBook Pros all the way to 2018, they were plagued with problems. So what Apple did in 2019, they brought out a brand new Magic Keyboard mechanism that worked completely different to the butterfly keyboard, but on the surface, if you actually compared the looks of say a 2018 MacBook Pro to a 2019 MacBook Pro keyboard, they didn't look any different. But like I said, the actual keyboard worked very differently underneath. Like I said, it is most likely, if we're expecting any changes from Apple on the newly designed MacBook Pros, it will be small tweaks like this one with like the keyboard, for example, even though the keyboard is great on the M1 Pro and the M1 Max MacBook Pros. However, we'll be getting upgraded chipsets inside the MacBook Pros, will include the M2 Pro and the M2 Max chipsets, and I'll be covering more details about these in an upcoming video. But for now, the main thing to take away is the actual design of the MacBook Pros are probably not going to really change for the next release, except for underneath the hood, where we're going to be getting that brand new M2 Pro and M2 Max chipsets. I also want to comment at this stage into the video that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof they will come true with the new MacBooks. Like I have said before in many of my other videos, I can only present to you what has been told and shown. However, if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So, release date is next. So that big question on the release date, when will we get our hands on the MacBook Pros? Well, it all really depends on what happens in spring 2022. And what I mean by this is Apple usually do an event at this time of the year. They normally do one around about springtime or announce a few new products around this time. If Apple introduce further Mac models to have the M1 Pro and the M1 Max inside them at this spring event, then the M2 normal chipset, like we had the normal M1 chipset, will probably be delayed until October or November time in 2022. That means more devices in spring 2023 would get that normal M2 chipset inside them, and then we wouldn't see the introduction of the M2 Pro and the M2 Ultra until the fall of 2023. However, I will say this, if we did see the introduction of the M2 chipset in spring 2022, there is a possibility that we might see the updated M2 Pro and M2 Max chipsets in the MacBook Pros in the fall of 2022. From my opinion though, I think the former will happen, where we probably won't see the MacBook Pros updated until fall 2023. Remember, there are still some Macs out there that have Intel chipsets inside them. For example, the 27-inch iMac and the higher spec Mac Mini still need updating with the M1 Pro and the M1 Max inside, or dual versions of these chips inside them. Then of course we still have the Mac Pro Tower desktop, again what is running on Intel Xeon chips that need upgrading to something like the M1 Ultra for example. So again, we're going to have to wait for some time before Apple do a refresh on the M1 Pro and the M1 Max chipsets to bring them into the next generation.
Just quickly, I want to talk about today's sponsor from Nord Security, and that is NordLayer. So, in the last couple of years, a lot of businesses out there have allowed their users or their employees to work from home. However, a lot of businesses out there want to know if the users' devices that they are using are safe and protected, especially like when transferring confidential files between the user's computer and, say, business servers. This is where NordLayer comes in. NordLayer gives that overall all-round package, what not only just encrypts the connection between a user's computer and business's servers, but also will save you from costly damages of confidential data leaks. NordLayer secures remote workforces, and also you have the ability to set up IP whitelists. So this basically means you can set up certain rules that permit users to access only what their roles allow. With NordLayer, you are protecting business critical data and resources by creating encrypted tunnel connections, verifying users' identity by biometric and multi-factor authentication, and enabling conditional access to different business applications to their respective authorized users. If you want to get a 20% discount off NordLayer, all you need to do is type in the code LayerMacTalksTech at the website www.nordlayer.com/MacTalksTech, and I'll also put those details in my description as well. Well, let's return back to the video.
With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far that previous leaks have painted a picture of what details the new MacBook Pros will give us with their baseline price as well. So starting out with the MacBook Pro 14-inch with the M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset inside it. It will be very similar, as I've already said in other parts of this video. So we'll be getting a 14-inch XDR Retina display, which is a mini LED display with a resolution of 3024 by 1964. And this is a ProMotion adaptive refresh rate display with 120Hz or up to 120Hz, like what we have right now with the M1 Pro and M1 Max 14-inch MacBook Pros. Storage will be very similar again. We'll have 512GB all the way up to 8TB. Inside it for chipset, we'll get that M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset. And this will be an option of an 8 or 10 core option. So if you go with the lower spec M2 Pro, you'll get 8 cores. But if you go for the standard M2 Pro, and also if you get the M2 Max, you'll get a 10 core CPU. and the same again for the GPU. It depends. So if you go for that lower spec M2 Pro, the first sort of baseline model, you'll get a 14 core GPU, but it goes up to 16 core and then up to 24 cores, then 32 core GPU. And this depends on what you pick with either an M2 Pro or you get yourself the M2 Max. Very similar to what we have right now with the M1 Max and the M1 Pro. For RAM, there isn't going to be much differences in the next generation of this MacBook Pro. You'll get the option of either 16, 32 or 64 gigabytes of RAM. And a lot of you out there will know if you've got the M1 Pro or the M1 Max that 16 gigabytes of RAM inside this machine compared to say 16 gigabytes of RAM in an Intel MacBook Pro, you will know this is very different indeed in how this is handled. So 16 gigabytes is really quite enough for quite a lot of people out there. The body again will be an aluminium body, and then for ports wise we will get the MagSafe, we'll get the three USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI 2.1 and then also an SD card slot as well. Then for the webcam in that notch in the middle, it's likely it's going to be upgraded to a center stage webcam at last, and that will also be a 1080p camera. For battery life, because of efficiencies in that M2 Pro and M2 Max chipset, we will probably get a slightly larger battery life. We will actually now get 18 hours instead of the 17 hours. But for price wise, the baseline MacBook Pro, we will probably get an M2 Pro. This is one with the 8 core CPU and 14 core GPU with 16 gigabytes of RAM and 512 gigabytes of storage. Will start at probably around the same price that we have right now, what is $1,999. Moving on to the 16-inch MacBook Pro with that M2 Pro and M2 Max, again the story is very similar. It will come with a 16.2 XDR Liquid Retina mini LED display with a resolution of 3,456 by 2,234, and it will be one of those adaptive ProMotion displays of up to 120Hz, just like we have right now. For storage options, it will be very similar again. It'll be 512GB all the way up to 8TB storage options. And then for the CPU, we'll have the choice of an M2 Pro or an M2 Max, and they will start at a 10 core CPU, and then you'll be able to have the choice of either 16, 24 or 32 core GPU, depending if you pick the M2 Pro or the M2 Max, and then obviously the different options that are available there. Then for RAM amounts, they will be the same again. So this will be 16, 32 and 64 gigabytes of RAM. And like I just said for the 14 inch MacBook Pro, 16 gigabytes might not seem a lot, but actually it handles it very differently, the MacBook Pro, to the likes of an Intel MacBook Pro with this Apple Silicon chipset inside it. The body will be an aluminium body again, and ports wise we will get MagSafe, three USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI 2.1 and an SD card slot as well. And then we should hopefully get that upgrade to center stage with the webcam, what will be a 1080p camera in that notch in the middle. Battery life this time will be up to 22 hours, so we get an extra hour, and that's mainly due to those efficiencies with the M2 Pro and also the M2 Max chipset. Then for the price wise, for based on the M2 Pro with a 10 core CPU, 16 core GPU, 16 gigabytes of RAM and 512 gigabytes, so this is the baseline version, it will start at $2,499. So that is a summary of the new MacBook Pros. However, for my thoughts and wishes, well, my thoughts and wishes are to do with actually the current M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBook Pros. I am hoping that when the new M2 Pro and Max comes out, that Apple still sells the M1 Pro and M1 Max MacBooks, but at a lower price. I am thinking something along the lines of what Apple do right now with iPhones. So each year when the new iPhone comes out, we still sell, or Apple still sell, a variant of the last generation or two of those models of the last generations for a bit less than what they were a year ago. I would love to see this happen to the M1 Pro and the M1 Max MacBook Pros, as they are such amazing devices and will be for many, many years to come. I would hope that the 14-inch base model, for example, would be reduced to, say, $1,799 compared to the M2 Pro base model that will be probably about the same at $1,999 that we pay right now for the current model. Do you think this would be a good idea? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below whether you agree with this or not. And also, let me know what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Pros. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon.